You may not think of walking on a treadmill as one of life's most victorious moments, but if it had been years or even decades since you've been able to stand, your heart would race to feel your feet move beneath you. After seeing quadriplegic actor Christopher Reeve walk on a crude manually assisted treadmill device at UCLA, HealthSouth founder Richard Scrushy and renowned neurosurgeon Suede were enthusiastic about the benefits this type of device could offer patients and immediately called on mechanical engineer Gary West to design a more advanced model. Scrushy, Suede, and West met to discuss this exciting venture. And in little over a year, in June 2000, the first working model of HealthSouth's auto ambulator was unveiled. The auto ambulator is a remarkable improvement on the device Christopher Reeve used at UCLA and is currently the most advanced model available. It's an amazing medical breakthrough that offers hope to those who dream of standing and walking again. On August 4th, 2000, HealthSouth spokesman Doug Heir, a record-breaking paraplegic gold medalist, Wheaties champion, and Sports Hall of Famer, finally realized the moment he had been anticipating for more than two decades. He took the first step since his paralysis with help from the auto ambulator.
When I first got hurt, they kept telling me that one day I'll walk again, and I often think how great it would be to walk again, and I dream about that, and walk, it would just be such a blessing. Because when you sit all day in the same position and you get tired of sitting, your back hurts after time and you're uncomfortable and you're slouching, and I am truly looking forward to the future, because I believe that one day I will be able to walk. Having that chance to stand again and moving your whole body and getting your whole body involved, it's like you're a full person. You're not just from here up. You're from here all the way down to your feet.
You break your neck, you think your life is over. And, thanks to God and my family and the HealthSouth, my life isn't over. It's just been a wonderful journey. And today is another journey, something I thought would never be possible. And in a few minutes, I'll be able to stand and take steps actually and moving my legs and operating my body, and I couldn't even sleep last night. I was just so excited about it. So I feel like a little kid.
I love you. Love you, Doug.
I love you, too.
Doug, we've got some special guests here that I want to ask them to come up and join us, and I know you want to say a few words, but let me ask Corey Everson and Herschel Walker, Matt Barr, Steve DiAsi, Jennifer Chandler, and Rowdy Gaines. Let's see who else we got here. I think that's the crew. Y'all come on out here. And I know they wanted to say something, but first, y'all come on out. But first, I know you want to make a couple of comments.
Oh, absolutely.
About your exercise and about you walking in this device.
Oh, terrific. Well, first, Rich, give me 1 second. Can I give you a hug? I haven't given you a hug standing ever. Hey, I love you. Thank you. Thank you. I guess it's hard to explain when you can't walk and then you can stand up and walk and move your limbs. And, when I was at the Olympics this summer and I had the honor of being the U.S. team captain, and there were some of the wheelchair racers there, the best racers in the world, and they asked me if I could be their lawyer and have the doctor amputate their legs because they said they're useless. I said, what's the sense of bothering with their legs? They'd be faster, their heart would pump better, their arms work better. And I said, just wait. There's something coming out that's incredible. And for me today to stand here among you and to be with Mr. Scrushy and then have Dr. Suede, standing next to me and encourage me, and having Beth, who has helped me the therapists have been tremendous, and Gary West and Jeff, who came up with this. And you know, last night when I was walking back to my room, I ran into Corey, and she said, "Don't be nervous about today." And Herschel walked me back to my room, and I, you know, to be with my best friends in the world, and Jennifer and Steve and Matt and Rowdy, and to have all of you here today. You know, when I broke my neck, I thought my life was over, and there was nothing to look forward to. And HealthSouth taught me, you know, to live life again, and you know, get an education and become a lawyer, and you could get dressed. We used to be 4 hours in the morning to get dressed. Now it takes me just a few minutes. And I was in the Bahamas earlier this week, and I'm swimming in the ocean, and I'm thinking how good life is and how grateful I am to all the administrators and to all the physical therapists that taught me how to be able to get into the water and go swimming and get dressed, and all the occupational therapists and Krista who helped me with different things as an OT. And you know, I'm sitting there eating my food, and I don't need utensils anymore to, you know, besides a fork and knife to eat. And I'm sitting there at the blackjack table thinking of Phil, and I'm putting my chips out on the table. I'm thinking how good that feels to do all these great things, you know. And so I'm grateful to all of you, because, you know, this is, for me, it's easy to stand here. It took all of you to make this possible. Mr. Scrushy, you know, I feel like I walk among giants today, because I know the difference that all of you make in the lives of so many people. And at times, you know, you may forget the goodness that you do on a daily basis. And I'm the president of the National Spinal Cord Injury Association. And if you could see the emails that I receive daily from people that have lost hope and people that want to commit suicide, and I tell them, just wait. The auto ambulator's coming out, there's hope. There'll be a cure one day, but until that happens, you will be able to walk. And I've walked miles already on this, and I haven't walked in 20 years, and I'm not dizzy, I feel great, I haven't had a problem. And behind stage, there are paramedics and people here ready to help me, and Dr. Sway's ready. But there's nothing, I mean, I feel totally great. I don't even want to go back in my wheelchair, but I know in a couple hours, they're gonna say, okay, you gotta get down now, go back in your chair. But it's a blessing, and I am so excited for all the facilities that are gonna have these, because I could travel around the country and walk. You know, granted, you know, it's tough being in a wheelchair, but not really. I mean, you can still live a full life, and I have a full life, and I've accomplished many of my dreams and goals that I never thought were possible. And I'm not missing out on anything with the laws and the Americans with Disabilities Act and great things that are happening. But if incorporating walking into my everyday lifestyle is incredible, and I feel I'm missing nothing now. And I do look forward to a day where there's a total cure. But until this comes, I wish my family was here with me today, but I consider everyone at HealthSouth and Mr. Scrushy my family and my dearest friends in the world. And, you know, coming in, flying in on the plane, and I had Brooks pick me up, and Joey's there, and then Sean, and, you know, just so many wonderful people that have helped me over the years, and Diana and Karen, and I mean, just tons of names that I can name, and I hope all of you could share in this celebration today. And, you know, as I hug Mrs. Scrushy, if I could ask all of you now to give yourselves a big hug and hug the person next to you right now, because today really is a celebration of life. It's a celebration of history. So make this a special moment, you guys. But I want to thank you. You know, the lives that you're going to touch now and what HealthSouth is doing, I mean, we're part of history. And when I was speaking with the therapist and Mrs. Scrushy and Dr. Sweet, there are no books written about this. And, you know, you're making history. And I just can't imagine when you break your neck now, or you break your back, God forbid, that your family could see you up and walking within a matter of weeks, if not sooner. And that whole mental attitude is just different. I think it will restore people's faith and hope, give them that enthusiasm where instead of lying in bed dreading going to therapy, there's going to be lines out the door waiting to get into therapy. So God bless all of you. And to the inventors of this, and Mr. Scrushy and Dr. Swade, I thank you with all my heart. And this is, you know, I've accomplished a lot in my life, but this is one of my greatest moments ever to be with all of you today. So thank you very much.
Thank you, Doug. You know, Doug. There are a lot of
thanks, Matt.
There are a lot of patients that will receive the benefit of this machine over the years and in the future. Not only patients with spinal cord injuries, but stroke patients and many others. And we're really excited that HealthSouth is moving forward at the rapid pace that we are. And as we experienced the Crystal Reeve situation and we saw the need, and of course, Doug, to have you here and to have you be part of this and to work with us on this project is outstanding. And you got some other great friends here, and I know they want to make a couple of comments.
You know, I've looked up to Doug in so many different ways. I didn't think there was any other way I could look up to this man. But to see him walking in this machine and to know that when he walks again without the machine, I think I'll have two more ways to look up to my very good friend, Doug Heir.
Thanks, man. Thank you.
I can remember the first time you called me, Doug, and you said, what do you doing next week? And I said, I don't know, just working. And you said, well, I'm coming to Birmingham to walk. You want to come over? That was so awesome. And you continue to inspire me. I mean, you have more courage than anyone I have ever met in my life, and I'm just proud to be your friend, Doug. I love you.
I love you, too. Thank you.
I did run into Doug yesterday, and he was really nervous, which is surprising to me because he's got this obsession with gold medals, 278 gold medals. He's captain of the Olympic team, but he's nervous to come out, you know, and walk. And I'm like, what makes you so nervous? And he said, well, I don't know anybody in the Olympics, and I don't know anybody in the audience, but these are my friends. Hell South, you are all my friends. And he was so nervous something was going to go wrong. You know, it was amazing to me, you know, that this was making him nervous. I have to tell you just a real quick story. I overheard Doug on my microphone at the road show, at one of the last shows, and he was talking to one of these little kids, and he was saying, your job in this life is to make this world a better world. And this little kid was like, well, yeah, right, I'm a C student. How am I going to do that? You know, I can't even get good grades. The world is so confusing and complicated. And Doug said, it all starts by building a better you. And that's exactly what every one of us needs to do. Doug, we love you more than you will ever know. You. Thank you.
That's great. Thank you. Wow. Nice score.
You know, it's all about family. And we are family up here, and we go through good times and we go through bad times, and we represent you, and you are our family, and I just can't wait to get you in the ocean to swim in again. You mentioned swimming.
Yeah, I need your help.
Hey, listen, you're working on my forte. I need those swim lessons. Great job, buddy.
You know, Doug's the one that's hooked up to all the machines and the heart monitor. I think I need a little bit of a heart monitor just seeing Doug up there right now. You know, it's not as if I needed another reason to be proud of Doug Heir and to be happy to be his friend. And you know what? It's not as if I needed another reason to be proud of being affiliated with Health South and with all the people out there. It's been a phenomenal scenario, and Doug, you're the best, and I'm glad that you're my friend, and I'm glad that we're all part of Health South.
Thank you, Steve. That's incredible.
Well, Doug, I think a long time ago I told you that you're an inspiration to me. And, you know, people always ask me, what would I want my son to grow up to be like me? And I think now I can tell him, no, I want him to have the heart and courage of Doug Ayers, because this is special. You've always been special to me, and I think you know that, and I love you. Thanks.
I love you. Thanks, sir. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you all for your comments.
Thank you.
This is our team.
These folks
have dedicated their lives to young children all across America, and they've set example, and I love them, and I thank you all so much. God bless all of you, and thank you for being here. Give another round.
Thank you.
Listen.
Thank you, guys.
Thank
you. It's quite a group of friends to have, you know? Oh, terrific. This you know, and the Go For It show is just incredible. I don't know if anybody's had a chance to see it. I'm sure a lot of you have. But the lives that the athletes and my truest friends in life, I mean, it's a great group of friends to have, you know? And the lives that are just touching is incredible. So Hell South is an amazing company. I hope all of you are very proud to be part of this incredible company. Well, thank you,
Doug, what do you say, let's go to the park?
Okay, let's go to Disney World. I'm ready.
Doug, when you think about Dr. Suede and Gary West, and Dr. Suede, where's Dr. Suede? And the work that he put into this. Where is he? Stand up, Dr. Suede. And Gary West, the mechanical engineer. Where's Gary? Come out here. Look at this. This guy used to be known for the fact that he built a piece of equipment for Mars or Milky Ways that makes Skittles. But now he'll be known for making Doug Heir walk again, and people all over the world. Thank you, Gary. Doug, thanks again.
Thank you.
We're just getting started. Gary's ready to go to production with the new units. And there will be a time when we're able to offer everybody in America that needs to be in one of these units the opportunity to do so. Thank you, Doug.
Thank you.
Have a good day at the park.
God bless.
We love you, man.
Thank you.